yeah. I stare.
Prepare my meals with them spices and herbs.
And herbs.
I'm in love with the way you serve.
You serve.
Really appreciate everything you do.
You do.
Living proof of Proverbs 18:22.
22.
Submissive ribs.
Submissive ribs.
Submissive ribs.
That you will.
My heart's burning passion for you dissolves my desire for any other woman I previously lust. I may have wanted to hold our telepathy and your connection to me, respectively, renders you the perfect mate that resonates straight from my soul. I have scrolled through holy scrolls, wrote notes and
composed. Right, so shalom. But when I enter your senses, under the sounds of the voice, the page,
then pray to your door, raise you from your stage of these modernized ways.
I asked them to say, I was talking to you a couple days ago
from that day, God bless me.
About the
and
techniques
this is my essay that reveals pictures of us in detail, like an X-ray.
Me,
Christ's message to me flourished your essence through repentance and acceptance. You became my blessing. We are forwardly stepping on with biblical lessons. You are essential like the breath of me, not secondary.
Properly, we're trying to put
makes you vital like my health.
So hopefully the good brother Marty Mars
to colonize existent in the
I can give you the G code, man. A lot of you whether you admit it or not, you be simping like hard body. Get with these women, think it's a right woman. And she end up taking you to the bank, trying to take you for everything you got. You don't want to listen until it's too late. But this is G Code. So today what we're gonna do, we're gonna go over the fundamentals about how to attract women. You're gonna attract them if you use these techniques now. Why is that important? Because it gives you the opportunity to be selective, to choose if that's the one for you. You need to listen to this, Yasha Allah, Arizona. You've been missing in action, man. The spirit of the Most High is not rolling with you right now, okay? You're not moving with the camp, man. You're trying to be an individual white instead of Israelite. It's not what it is, man. You gotta be a family, man. You gotta form. Like Voltron, that'll come together.
Converses with angels.
Nevertheless,
about Malik, Tamika, Maria, I call
this the title Doc 7.
The reason I named those
these
is because they're too blind to see how Satan games goes. I am that I am.
Give me one second, man. I'm about to give you seven techniques
says,
that I call title Doc 7 techniques.
Yeah, we remain a mystery.
The title Doc 7
because the system hit our history.
Never felt.
Her children, she and me. Now for most to discern the facts from the fiction is that Esau.
Good,
woman, but facts do not cease to exist because they are ignored.
Utilize
I am the factor.
But,
I am here and after the storm, after the laughter. Now,
don't
I'm
just
after
go
you.
And you know, pick any woman because she's attracted.
Sister, you'd
fill her out. A lot of you've actually you already made that mistake.
Run.
Wait a second, I'm trying
faster.
To see if I can find money on this email.
Chiclack, wrong color. You should not have ran black. Once you sold your soul, you can never run back. Submissive
red. His will, raising my offspring with tender loving care. Around the house, sometimes I stop and prepare my meals with some spices and herbs. I'm in love.
There's seven techniques.
Tell
Doc 7.
Appreciate
everything. Who's our email, Mr. Brother?
Living proof of Proverbs 18:22.
And we will be on again tonight. Most High willing. And we're going to talk more about the scriptures. But for right now, teaching you how to attract women. And you can discern which ones you want or which one you want. And which one. Oh, that's my man right there, Marty Ma. You in the mind. You in here. You up in here. Good. I try to just shoot you an email. So basically, my man, Marty Ma. There's seven fundamental techniques for attracting women. Don't, no matter how she look, most people make the mistake that better she look to you, the higher you raise her level. You got to treat them all the same. I call these the Taza Doc 7. There's seven basic things that attract women. Most of them don't even know this is what attracts them, right? And even if she hears this, even if a female goes and listens to this video, she still won't be able to avoid it because it's part of her psyche. This is the G code, G-gun. Now, all but one are truly important, which is actually the last one. The last one is not really that important. All the other ones is very essential. Seven things that attract most women. First thing, Marty Martin, is wealth, money, bread, meaning how much money you have and how much you earn. This is why so many of these women are attracted to celebrities and stars. Women wouldn't mind having a partner who has a lots of money because it would be the perfect provider. You understand? But this needs to be purely a survival strategy and hasn't changed over centuries, right? That's a need. That's a need that she has. Now, the most common reason why women are these damn gold diggers, because many of them are gold diggers, right? Like wealthy men, is it's pretty obvious, Marty Ma. It's pretty obvious. Yasha Allah. Because they could buy lots of stuff, like hundreds of shoes, clothes, jewelry, you know, just hypothetically, generally speaking, right? Provide a better lifestyle. These are all of the reasons she likes a man that has a lot of money. They also are attracted to the idea of never having to work or worry about money anymore. You hear Keisha talk, Salakia, Kimberly talking about that on the call. It would be nice to have a man that could be a provider, right? Showing you how they think. I listen to people when they talk, okay? I'm very analytical, right? Now, does that mean you can't get a beautiful woman, Marty Moore, if you're poor? Nah, homie, you couldn't be more wrong from the truth. You couldn't be more off here, right? Women do prefer, they do prefer the rich guy over the poor guy. But even if you do have money, it doesn't mean jack, because there's a lot of simps that have a lot of money. The next thing is looks, how you look, right? Most women say that they want a guy that is cute, that is tall, that is handsome. If you look like Denzel Washington when he was younger, Brad Pitt, if you're an Edomite, Johnny Depp, I don't know what the hell they saw in him. You know what I mean? Michael Jackson, so on and so forth. Women get attracted to you instantly. Now, let me give G. Cole. Need to listen to this, Tariq, the Mac, right? You're the Mac, right? You should be teaching this class, not me, Tariq. You're the Mac. But there's a problem with this, right? There's a problem here. Looks alone, it gives you a lot more attention, and it is not really a crucial factor in how successful you are with women. Same goes for height. They might like a man that's tall, but you don't need to be tall to be a ladies' man. Why do you think that most of the guys that are really successful, you know, playboys and so on and so forth, or ladies' men, are not rich, are not tall, and don't have the model looks? Now, to keep it a buck, right? We can keep it 2 grand today. Tomorrow, we'll keep it a Franklin. Still, it's 100. To be keeping it real, son, some of them that, some people that, you know, I mean, I used to roll with, man. Some of my close friends, they were like, just like, you know what I mean, average dude. They don't shower regularly. You know what I mean? I'm just keeping it a buck, right? And so you really need to come off of that trip about it's how you look. Because I know dudes that didn't even shower regularly. I had to tell them, yo, man, why don't you wash your stinking ass? Go and take a shower. He still was good with chicks, man. He still was good with chicks. So you need to get off of that trip. You need to get off of that bit about that your looks give you a huge edge in attraction or in the dating game. It's not true. It's not true. Next thing is power. Power, right? Now, power is a form of dominance, right? And it shows your leadership qualities. Women are always attracted to real leaders, right? They're attracted to leaders, man. Something about it turns them on, man. You understand? And women always go to the leader of the pack. You know what you guys call him? The alpha male. See, you don't need to be a senator. You don't need to be a Donald Duck. Did I say Trump? Or a powerful businessman to qualify for this department. You know, nah, you ain't got to be that money, ma. Don't believe the hype. But the fact is that women find themselves naturally. I'm telling you, this isn't her psyche. This is part of her psyche. She's natural. And if any woman tell her, nah, that's not true, don't believe her, man. Believe me. Don't believe her, right? Don't believe her, because if you use these tactics, you're going to have her somewhere in the telly or on the back seat of your Jeep with her legs in the air, just keeping her in a box. I'm not telling you to do that, man. Because if you're an Israelite, that's supposed to come with commitments. But I know what works, King. I know what works. You understand? So you don't need to be a senator, any of that. Some no powerful businessman. But the fact is, women find themselves naturally attracted to a guy who has lots of power. Why? Because it's sexy. It brings respect and shows you are not at the bottom of the food chain. So we got three right there. Well, fame. Were they like celebrities? Look at this punk dude, man, that just came out of jail for being a damn snitch. And we got, what, 2 million views on Instagram? The 6ix9ine? Just from fame. Fame, man. I know that's like, damn, man, really? See, if you're famous, then people will recognize you on the street because they already know you. People think that if you're famous, you're better than the average man or woman. Truth be told, man. Now, of course, this is not. It's complete BS. That doesn't make you any better, right? Look at Paris Hilton, for example. Right? But this is just the way it works in this world. This is how people's mind are made to think. Unfortunately, my niggas, N-E-G-U-S, 99.9% of men are not famous and can't capitalize on this attraction trait. Nevertheless, women are attracted to the guys that get famous. So you better turn yourself into a YouTube superstar overnight. Christ, the God power. Number five, status. What is your status? Men who have status have influence and power, and usually they got that bread. This is almost the complete package, right? A power and fame. I had a woman once tell me, wow, you're the complete package. You work out, you're handsome, you got bread, you're the complete package. It's like, yeah, but I'm not into you. You're not even one third of the unpackers. See ya. Real talk. I can't make it up, man. So this is almost like the complete package of power and fame, right? When you have status, that means you got the power and the fame. So if you have status, then people will assume that you're somehow better than someone who doesn't have status. Check this out. G code. Here's another code, right? G code. If a woman, I'm going to tell you something, man. Listen to this, man. Listen to this, King. If a woman see other women eyeballing you, if a woman see other women eyeballing you or trying to get your attention, your status raises instantly in their eyes. In their eyes. In all of their eyes. In all women. In the eyes of all women. You ever wonder why, Marty Marr, when you're single, women are not as attracted to you? And you'd be like, damn, where was she when I was married, when I was in a relationship? You know why? Your status goes up when women see you with other women. That's how Eve is, man. She always wants someone else that belongs with someone. I'm giving you the game, man. G-code. Straight like that, man. So your status goes up when she sees you with another woman. They very competitive when it comes to stuff like that. You know what I mean? Real talk, man. Understand what I'm saying? Universal sovereign soul. It's real, man. It's real in the film. And that's all women, right? So that you by yourself, she typically won't give you as much attention, man. You come through. You got a bad bar with you. She's like, damn, he must have something good. He's with her. That's how they think, man. That's part of their psyche. And this is because women tend to follow. And if they see other women being interested in you, then you must be sexy for every woman. Do you get it? If you don't get it, man, you're going to slip up, man. Number six. Rule number six, man, of the seven. Yeah, I mean, I'm going to give you seven, man. I'm going to give you seven that I call the Tazadok seven. Seven fundamentals that attract women. Number six, talent. Talent. See that dudes that rap? You know why a lot of these Israelites go and rap? Because they cornballs otherwise, right? Not all of them, just a lot of them. They know that if you got some kind of talent, women are attracted to that. Men who have talents are seen as attractive because women feel like they could actually provide for her. That's the reason. It also means that if you have talent, you are actually being regarded as someone special who makes you unique and different. Women like men that are different. So having a special talent is a great turn-on and automatically makes you stand out from the crowd. Or this, he can rap. It's good. Don't try and become a rapper, Marley Mar. Might not work for you. So if you're good at what you do, whatever it is, and you're enthusiastic about it, that attracts it even more. This is why they go so crazy over damn singers, man. Stop me where I'm lying at. That's how we own it. Number seven. Rule number seven is personality. In the hood, we call it swag. How's your swag, Jimmy Licia? You got swag? Rule number seven is personality. Swag. This is more important than any of the other ones. Swag. Swag. This is important to more important than money, more important than talent, more important than fame. You understand? More important than your looks is swag. It's more important than talent, more important than all of it. If you don't hear nothing else I said, you better hear this one. This is the G code, man. Your personality, your swag, Jimmy, Marty, is your greatest weapon and tool when it comes to success in the dating game. If it wasn't for your personality, then almost all men out there who enjoy great success with women wouldn't be where they are right now. See, it's your swag, Jimmy. It's your personality. Your personality is the only thing that you could actually tweak and improve in a short amount of time. You can't become rich overnight unless you hit the lottery. Can't grow tall if you're ugly. You can't change that. You ugly. God made you ugly. Salaki, I don't want to use that word God anymore. Yahweh made you ugly. So you better develop some swag, man. You better have some swag like I don't know what. You better have some swag like a mofo. If people are calling you ugly all your life, forget about it. You better develop that swag, man. That's the most important element of this, man. Because, man, if it wasn't for your personality, then all men out here who enjoy great success with women, they wouldn't be where they are. Your personality is the only thing that you could actually change, alter, tweak, and improve in a short amount of time. I mean, you won't get rich overnight, right? And you're definitely not going to grow taller overnight. You're not going to grow any more inches if you already adore. But your personality is crucial. It's essential when it comes to meeting and dating beautiful women. I'm going to show you, man. I'm going to show you, Marty Ma, how you could actually train your personality into an irresistible powerhouse. Real talk, man. Real talk. Your personality decides whether or not a woman will ultimately want to be with you and love you. believe it or not. See, it's your personality that makes a woman feel turned on, excited, happy, intrigued, and get that gut feeling cool, attracted, and then say, I love you. None of the others can do that as intense as your personality, Jimmy LaShia. You understand? Check this out, right? I know you don't really believe me. You may not really believe me, right? You probably really don't believe me, right? That just by boosting or tweaking someone's personality, you will get ultimate success with women. It's true, man. Most guys don't believe me when I tell them this. They want to go and do what they was doing the regular way and they get the same old results, which is nothing. A jar of Vaseline or damn jar of petroleum jelly and damn porn movies. Sitting on their damn sofa dreaming. Committing adultery of the heart. But once you have that swag, man, Once you've seen all of my techniques and the actions, the jaw suddenly drops, the eyes open in astonishment, and all they can say is, wow. Check this out, right? I have a lot of people, man, that I used to like kick it with. A lot of so-called homies, man. They consider themselves to be players, right? They consider themselves to be players, right? Some of the best people when it came to seducing women and womanizers, right? Right? And we pretty much kept everything quiet and in the underground. But me and some of the cats that I run with is a living proof that the stuff that I'm telling you works, man. It works. I'm not rich. I'm not poor. You know what I mean? None of that. I mean, I'm not driving in the G-Wagon. But the reason and the only reason why I could be successful and was successful at what I do is because I perfected my craft. I perfected my swag. I perfected my personality to naturally attract women everywhere I would go. I had to put a lot of effort into this, man. And if nothing works, I would change it. But nothing works better than my swag, than my personality when I wanted to get a woman's phone number and get a date with her. It was always my swag that did it. And to be honest, it's pretty much on autopilot right now. You become subconscious of it, right? But I was a struggling nice guy at one point, like many of you guys, right? Like many of you guys listening to this. And all I could do at this point was to fix and enhance my swag, my personality that would actually attract women in the near future. And guess what? Voila, it works. I'm not rich. I'm not any taller than I was 10 years ago. You understand? But I alter my personality. Absolute killer. Mark the game with my swag. See, it's the reason why I'm such a chick magnet. I'm keeping a buck, Jimmy, Alicia. When I was in the war, I was a chick magnet, man. All kind of chicks pushing up, walking through the mall. Yeah, what's that guy? Sending someone over, he got so-and-so want to talk to you. Chick magnet, man. You know what I mean? Real talk, Jimmy. Alicia, I'm not bragging, man. I'm like a chick magnet, man. And so I'm going to show you, man, how you could become the same, man. I'm not telling you to go out and do what I've done. I was wicked back then. So you see that the best thing about you is your swag, Marty Ma, your personality, right? Is that you, if you change that for the better, if you work on it, Now, it's difficult to change the way that you look, right? It's difficult to change your status. It's difficult to get rich overnight. But the strategy is most important. Your characteristics that you change about yourself. Personality traits, right? That attract women. I'm going to list an idea of what men should have and be like in order for them to consider you as a boyfriend, potential husband, a lover, whatever. You know what I mean? I'm going to give you the fundamental tools you could use to attract the woman. And I want you to go out and put them into practice, man, because it really works. Put it into practice. Marty, so you want two wives? Put this into practice, man. Then you need, when you get them, you know what I mean? You get each one of them, give me $100 a piece, man, because this is going to work, right? Now, put them into practice. Don't just watch these videos. Go and test it, man. When you go out in public, when you're talking to females, put them into practice, right? You'll see, damn, this stuff really works. So some of them are best on their own, whilst others can work well when you combine them with other techniques. First one I'm going to tell you is humor. Make a woman laugh and she will eat out of your hand. If you can make a woman smile, make her giggle, right? Laugh. It will bypass their bitch shell. Most women have a bitch shell that they have up when you first meet them. G-code, right? They can't give you attitude either because you've lowered your guard because they're laughing. So you lower her guard, should I say, because they're laughing. So it will also make you an interesting and fun person to hang out with. That's what she's going to remember if you make her laugh. Number two, dominance. Women love a man who takes charge and leads. This means she wants to be, she really wants to be led. It don't mean she wants to be locked up by you or anything like that. But she will love it when you're taking control of situations and make decisions. Case in point, right? You asked her out for where to go. You ask her out on a date. She says yes. Then you ask her, where do you want to go? That's a simp move right there. If you're the man, you tell her where we're going. You see what I'm saying? And you think something like that is small, but I'm telling you, man, that's part of taking charge. You got to already know where you're going, King. Women naturally follow. She's designed to receive a man both mentally and physically. Women naturally follow. So if you don't lead, you're going to have a problem, man. Big problems. Big problems. Next thing you got to have is confidence. You're all damn nervous. You're out on a date with her. Your damn bottle shaking like that. But she's so nervous. You think she's so beautiful. She done lost all attraction from you just because of that. What you need is some inner strength. Women are the weak ones. Remember that. I'm going to say that again. Women are the weak ones, right? So they need a strong counterpart. They need a strong covering. That's supposed to be you. Man the hell up. You have to make the decisions. Walk up to her. Do all the dirty work. Don't procrastinate. If she's saying no, keep it moving, man. Have a big ego. I'm not telling you to be big, hey? Yeah, have a big ego, man. See, make sure you're in love with yourself. And have a big ego. Just tell God, this goes against everything they teach me. Everything my parents teach me. Everything, yeah, because they ain't giving you the game, man. Yeah, your father, he was just one woman. He was just with one woman. Maybe two. I'm giving you G-codes, man. Stuff that I know that works. So you got to have a big ego, man. But don't take yourself too seriously. You got to play it down a notch. I know this sounds arrogant. She might call you narcissistic. Nah, man, if you play it right. Even though women say they want a nice guy, it's bullshit. They always end up with the slightly arrogant jerk who's full of himself. So make sure you use what works and get the big ego. Stop being a damn nice guy. If you've been a nice guy, sow seeds, you better sow some new seeds, man, and get an ego. Be cheeky. What do you mean by that? This is one of the most powerful and important tools there is. This is one of the most powerful tools you will ever learn. By being slightly arrogant and funny. And you being cheeky, and every woman will want to be around you because they feel you. They feel that gut level of emotion that magically attracts them to you. G-code, man. G-code. Be spontaneous and unpredictable. I'm a very unpredictable dude. I walk in, yo, let's go, man. We're going to Florida. Out of nowhere, we ain't planning nothing. Spontaneous dude, man. You might see me in any given state on any given day. Be spontaneous, man. Stop doing things that every damn routine. Don't signal your intentions. Stop telling her everything that you're going to do. Be spontaneous, man. Don't signal your intentions to her just like that. Be a little mysterious. Mystery is good. Always keep her on her toes, man. Keep her guessing. Say things she wouldn't expect. Make spontaneous decisions and don't reveal everything about yourself too damn early. You meet her, you running off at the mouth. That's feminine energy, man. Gotta bunk your ass down and build you back up. See, all of this makes you much more interesting. Every woman kind of knows how men behave or how her past dates went. So you have to show her that you're not like them. You gotta be dissident. You gotta be different. So by being spontaneous, unpredictable, and a little mysterious, you instantly come off as different, dissident, and special, making you seem like a hot, interesting man in a woman's eyes. G-code. It's the game, man. I'm giving you the game, man. Next thing, man, you're too damn easy. You got to be hard to get. You're the prize, man. Be hard to get. You got to be a challenge, man. Otherwise, women are going to lose interest in you, man. If they could get you without putting in any kind of effort or having to chase and fight to actually get you, she's just going to lose interest. You got to play hard to get. Don't call her on time. Don't call her all of the damn time. Don't respond to all of the damn text messages. You know what I mean? She texts you right away. You boom, you're on it. She's like, yeah, I got this. He's a simp. He's a simp. Can't do that, man. Know that just because she is beautiful doesn't mean you will want her on a date. You got to bring her down, man, no matter how attractive she is. Oh, yeah, he's going to like me. Nah, me. You got to be different. Make her chase you. You're the prize, man. Got to keep saying that until you get it in your head. If you don't believe it, it's not going to work for you. G-code. Make her chase you and not the other way around. If you don't do this, you're going to have a problem with women, man. And this is done by playing a little hard to get, by being busy sometime. Women usually do this to you. This is exactly what they do to you. You chasing her. You chasing her. Don't do everything for her. Whenever she wants you to, stop being a damn simp. I'll smack you with this damn Bible, man. Don't be doing everything for her, man, when she wants you to. Stop being a simp. Be a man. You a man, you can tell her no. And mean it. Do you understand? Don't do everything for her whenever she wants you to. You will have to play your own thing here. You also got to be charming. This isn't that easy, right? It doesn't mean that you should be all romantic like you're from Rome. You're a damn Israelite. You're not from Rome. You're not from Rome, so you can't be romantic. That's what you need to tell. I'm not from Rome, so don't expect me to be romantic. But you got to be a little charming, right? Goody-goody, right? So if you can acquire James Bond, right? He's always nice with the women, right? If you can acquire that strong James Bond charm that can sweep a woman off of her feet, then you're spot on. But by any means, do not be all cuddly. Always want to hand, hold up, kiss, become like a damn wet scent. You write her poems all the damn time. Always giving her gifts, always bringing flowers, taking her out to candlelight dinners. Come on, son. It doesn't work like that. You've been trying it. How's that working out for you? She lose interest in your behind. You got to have that charming personality. But don't try to be too damn romantic. You ain't from Rome. You don't even know how to be romantic. Are you a damn Roman? Come on, man. You need to turn up the heat by creating attraction and being charming, not romantic. Being romantic kills everything on you, man. You heard what I said? You got to turn up the heat by creating attraction. And being romantic kills everything. Oh, you guys don't understand this. What? The game that your fathers gave you was wrong, dead wrong. See, most guys make the mistake. So the woman backs off. You're trying to be old man. You're sending her flowers and all of that. Don't listen to that, man. Don't listen to women telling you, oh, send her flowers. Don't send her no damn flowers up. Next thing I'm going to tell you is be rebellious, man. If you follow all the rules that I'm giving you, if you don't be a little rebellious, if you're predictable, that means you're boring, right? Rules are made to be broken. Which woman don't love a guy that's a little bit wild, rebellious, and adventurous guy? She would try to tame you, kid. And that's half the fun. Right there. Right there for every woman on this planet. She ain't trying to tame you. They don't like the nicey guy. Nicey, nice guy, right? Who they know they can get at any time. There's no challenge in that. They want the rebels. I think I could break him. The bad boy. I think I could break him. He thinks he's so harsh. I could break him. Yeah, all right. Also got to be clever, man. See, women tend to be attracted to a sharp and bright mind. Intelligent man, right? As long as you're not a damn nerd, right? Or a damn geek. Women won't be interested in facts and statistics. But if you could actually show to a woman that you do have some brains, she would find that very attractive. See, being clever and street smart are both huge turn-ons for women. How I know? I asked them back in the day, man. This one chick that I was dealing with, I was like, what kind of man you like? She's like, I like him to be a little kind of thuggish and really intelligent. G-Code. Stop being a nice guy, Jimmy Alicia. Put your damn foot down, man. Put your foot down, Jimmy Alicia. Yeah, man. Be clever. Be street smart. Both of them. Huge turn on, man. Don't be a dumb crackerjack. You understand? And be original. Be different. Don't emulate other people, man. You got to have your own swag. Can't be emulating other people. Don't do the same thing that everyone else is doing. That's one of the damn things that I hate about New York. Everyone emulates everyone else. People go out and get with a certain style. Everyone got the damn thing on. I have my own style, man. Got my own swag, right? Do it different, man. Be different. Be dissident. Don't do the same thing every other guy does, man. Don't dress like every other guy. If you do, are you like every other guy that she's dated before? And so then why would she want you? What would she get out of that? See, the reason why
her past dates didn't go any further was simply because every man wasn't special. They weren't unique. They weren't different from each other. They was kind of like all the same. See, that's why my attraction techniques work so perfectly here. It would make you stand out, make you dissident, make you different from the rest. And therefore, you come off as sexy, an interesting guy that just about every woman wants to date. G. Coleman. Be cool, man. Be cool, Marty. That's a hard one to explain, right? But this is what it is, right? You just had to take it easy, man. Trying to meet women, dating women, shouldn't be a big deal for you. So you gotta have an attitude like you don't care, man. Another woman wants a piece of me, so let's see what she's got. Maybe I'll kiss her. Maybe I'll let her hang out with me. If she's interesting, I'll see. So many guys take this dating game, this game, way too seriously, right? There's no need to. Just relax, man. Play it cool, man. Play by your own rules. Do you. You will come off so much more confident if you're being yourself. You will come off sexy. You will come off as a challenge. Watch this, right? Obviously, every woman is different. But if you can acquire most of these personality traits that I've been talking about throughout this video, most women will not be able to resist you. I don't give a damn if they already know, they're not going to be able to resist you. The personality traits, right? The swag are what makes about 99% of women feel that gut level emotion called attraction towards you. See, the strongest one is that you could come off as slightly arrogant, but still funny. That's called being cheeky, right? So I haven't found a beautiful woman who was not attracted to me when I was cheeky to her. You understand what I'm saying? See, the only type of women that won't respond to you that well, if you have all these personality traits, are the ugly women. I'm just keeping a buck. These are the only kind of women that won't respond to you well are the ugly women. Why? G-Code. Because they know that most men don't find them attractive. And if you have an amazing personality that naturally attracts women, she knows she doesn't stand a chance. G. Cole, I'm telling you, man, listen to what I'm telling you. So a better, more beautiful woman can just come along and be instantly attracted to you as well. So she gets jealous and won't respond positively towards you. This is what the ugly women do. The ugly women and the overweight women would behave that way. But that would be the least of your problems, Marty Mar, because what you want is an intelligent, cute, beautiful woman, right? So why settle for what's unattractive? Why do it? Or why settle for what unattractive guys go for? I just gave you a choice. So now, you can now make almost any woman get sexually attracted to you. Because I'm telling you, these things turn her on sexually, right? She'll get sexually attracted to you. So, I want you to go out, Marty Ma, for the type of woman that you always wanted. And so another thing, right? Another thing I want to mention, good brother Marty Ma, is that most women say they want a man who's nice, who's good looking, who treats them well, like a princess, obviously, and plays the role of the perfect boyfriend. But in reality, the type of women me and you probably, and every other guy wants to be with, has never dated a guy like that, ever. Every man she's been out with wasn't nice, wasn't polite, or treated her like a princess. So if you are the perfect boyfriend, then you become boring, right? Being perfect in general, kings, my niggas, is just plain boring. Small difference and imperfections are exactly what makes someone or something else interesting. You get it? G-code. But you now know how attraction works, Marty Mark. So never listen to what a woman says she wants. Don't do it. Don't listen to her. Never listen to what a woman says she wants, Marty Mark. Pay attention to what is happening for real. Does she get what she wants? Does she go out with the guy she originally wanted to? No. She goes out with the guy that makes her feel sexually attracted. And all those guys have at least half of the personality traits that I just mentioned to you throughout this stream. That's one of the many secrets of this dating game. G-code. I'm glad that I taught you this just in time. Let me give you a little bit more, man. Let me give you a little bit more. Let me tell you this, Marty Ma. Why women bitch? Why do women bitch? See, women will give you some attitude and behave like a brat sometimes. Why? Why? See, most men just don't know what to do when your date or your girlfriend acts like a complete biatch. So I'm going to teach you why they do it and what to do about it to effectively handle the situation. First of all, you need to realize that women are emotional creatures, driven by emotions, and they love drama. That's why they watch the damn soap operas, things like that, Housewives of Hollywood, and so on and so forth. Their discussions are not based on pure logic, but rather how they feel at that given moment. That's exactly why most guys can't counter an argument with pure logic, because it becomes erratic. It doesn't sink into the woman's brain. So in other words, they just won't get it. If you are reasonable and try to explain it to them in logic, they will not get it. Do you know what's going on? Do you know what's going to happen? She would say, yeah, but the problem here isn't the bitch in itself, but how the man reacts to it. That's the problem. How you react to it. If you can't handle the situation and let her act like a brat, then she would get annoyed because you let her do it. It's just like that. When women get annoyed at you, when you ask the woman on a date, where do you want to go? Or what do you want to do? See, women will just say, I don't know. You want to translate that correctly? It translates to, why are you asking me? You're the man. Stop being a simp and listen to what I'm saying. You need to make the decisions. Don't ask me. I'm the woman. That's basically what she's saying to you. I'm supposed to follow. That's what she's saying to you on a subconscious level. Do you get it? Feel me? Another thing is the woman need emotions. That's what keeps them alive. And if you have needs to fulfill, then you need something that feeds them. In other words, you need drama. See, men don't really have that need, but you will have to know how to handle a woman when she gets emotion. When she gets emotional, when she gets into our emotions. So, what do you do when your woman or your date is being all emotional, acts like a bitch, and give you a little attitude, what do you do, Marnie Mark? What do you do, Jimmy? Will you let her have her way? Or you will have to let her know that, hey, she could do that with every other guy, but not with you. The buck stops here. Look, I know women like to bitch sometimes. But seriously, Marty Mark, stop behaving like a brat. This is what you got to tell her. Look, I know women like to bitch sometimes, but stop behaving like a brat. Serious tone, right? So you need to be able to hold your own ground, man. Not like George Zimmerman, but you damn sure need to stand your own ground. You need to be able to hold your own ground when you deal with a real hottie, because she will give you an attitude to see if you're up to the challenge. And if you're a weak punk simp, it's over for you. They would test you. They really do. They all do it all the time. So you have to make sure that you let her know what your rules are, how far they could go, and what you would tolerate, and what you won't tolerate. It's all about respect anyways. If you let her know, then she will accept it and respect your decisions. But if you don't, sayonara, son. She's going to leave you because she just turned you into a simp, and she's going to lose the attraction. If you don't put your foot down, she will walk all over you, Jimmy, Alicia, like a damn doormat, because you let her do it. Women don't have any respect for the nice guy that acts like wimps and simps and cucks. So behave like a man. Man up, Marty Ma. Man up. Nice guys always finish last. Always. Nice guys always finish last, right? They always do. I could go on and on and on. Let me see how long I've been talking here, man. I don't want to make this too long. So you want to be a nice guy? You're going to finish last. Now, all right, let me take it to another level, right? And explain why exactly being a nice guy to women is it's a very bad idea. I want you to think a bit, right? I want you to think, right? About 90% of guys who listen to me has actually hung out with me and kicked it to me in the past. And, you know, I try to deal with women. We're being labeled as nice guys by women in their past. Now, fortunately, their lives have actually taken a complete turn for the better. Now, there's a pretty big chance that you might have actually been what the women call a nice guy. Has that been you, Marty Ma? Did they call you a nice guy? See, you know, the type of man women like to hang out with, can share all their problems with, talk to you about their relationship problems, about other men, basically consider as a personal girlfriend. A damn simp, in other words. See, you wouldn't mind to kiss or sleep with her, even if that was just on a real date with her, but she doesn't feel the same way about you because you're a nice guy, you're a simp. So the big question I always get is, how can I get her? And what have I done wrong? See, the answer is actually pretty simple. If you paid attention to what I've been saying, you thought that by being a nice guy and polite to women, she would be nice to you as well and like you in the end. That's not how it works. Then you started buying her drinks, picking her up when she needed a lift. You even talk to her for hours on the damn phone. Let me tell you something, man. The phone is only used for making dates. You don't stay on the damn phone with a woman for an hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. The phone is used for making dates. And so you were still waiting for the right moment to kiss her and tell her how you really, really felt about her, how much you really liked her. Or maybe you did. And she just said that she needs some more space and needs some time to think about this. Or the most common response, why do you want to ruin our friendship that we have here? So if you ever try to kiss her, she would turn her head. If you went to go on a date with her, she would not treat it like a date, but like a get together with one of her girlfriends where you chat and talk about stuff over a cup of coffee at Starbucks or something. So why did this happen, family? Why did this happen, my niggas? Why does she think of you as just a friend? Remember Bismarcky's song, "You got what I need, but you say he's just a friend." You're that friend. You're that friend, right? It all leads back to when you first met her because you got put in the damn friend zone. That's when you lay out the ground rules and the foundation of the emotional connection between the two of you. Now, women don't get attracted to a nice guy. They don't get attracted to a clingy guy. They don't get attracted to a needy guy. They don't get attracted to simps, people with wimpy behavior. That's a fact, big facts. So if you were unable to press her emotional trigger buttons to make her feel that gut level emotion called attraction towards you, then something else will happen. You get put in the damn friend zone. You will send out, "I want to be friends," signal to her, not sexual mating indicators. Do you feel me, Tyreek the Mac? They will look at you and see that you're being a nice guy, indeed. But they just don't feel sexually attracted towards you. But because women don't tell you to fuck off if you didn't behave like a damn complete jerk, then she will let you be friends with her. And this is what happens. You know, yeah. Well, Tyreek, you know, you're a nice guy. But I just got out of a relationship. But we can still be friends, though. And you go like, "But I don't want to be friends. I want to date you. Duh. You just stand in your head. Duh. Like Homer Simpson. But it's too late. You already done laid the foundation, my dude. She has made you in her mind that you're just a friend. It's also a nice guy. It's also her nice way of saying, "I'm not really attracted to you, but you are sweet. I can't possibly give you a rude rejection because you're such a nice guy." So let's summarize all of this, my man, Tyreek. Women never, never, hear me, Marty Mark? So you're looking for two wives on crazy wild videos? Women will never sleep with clingy and wimpy simps. Never sleep with clingy and wimpy nice guys. They always date the bad boy, the guy that our society likes to call a menace, a thug, a bad influence, a jerk. Now, does that mean you have to become a jerk to get women? Hell no. You just need to take what works for the jerk, ditch everything else, what the nice guys do, and add the rest from Taza Doctrine, G-Code. Then you got it made. Right? I don't teach you to be mean. I don't teach you to be a mean bastard. I don't teach you to be a jerk. I just give you all the stuff that really works out here. It's real out here in the film. The true secrets are bagging birds or bagging chicks or attracting women. But just to get over this last one, please, please, please don't fall for the oldest trick in the book and believe that you should be a nice guy to women to become successful. In reality, on the streets, it just doesn't work. It don't work in real life. It don't work in real life. Feel me? First impressions. Everybody keeps talking about the first impression. Eh. Whatever, right? But what's really going on here is, why is a first impression so important? So I want to give you the game on that, right? I want to reveal the real game on that. Right now. And this will actually give you an incredible advantage. All right, check this out, right? Think about this for a moment. Muse over this. Why is a good first impression so essential? Real simple. Because you can't change it after a certain amount of time. Once a woman has made up her mind about you, you are literally screwed. Check this out, right? I get so many messages, emails from guys saying, yo, tell the doc, I was checking your videos out on Spokesman for Men, man, and I met this woman, and I think I blew it by being a nice guy and clingy. And she said she only wanted to be friends. I even tried to kiss her, but she always turned her face away. What can I do to win her over? So the answer is very cruel, but it's the truth. There's nothing that you could do, man. There's nothing you could do with her. That's over. Keep it moving. You blew it. You blew it by being a nice guy, by being wimpy, by being a simp. You have to move on, man. Next. That's all I can say. You have to start meeting other women, dating other women, courting other women, and get your game up, man. Get your G code up. Get your skills up. I've tried women, winning a lot of women over with some of these jealousies. And I'm not even going to lie. It does work. But the only way you could win a woman after you screwed up is if you have top-notch game. And if you do have an amazing skills, you won't screw up like this in the first place. I hope you can understand what I'm saying, right? This is why most mistakes either happen within the first 30 seconds to the first 3 minutes. You either screw up with a woman in the first 30 seconds or the first 3 minutes. Or at the date when you're trying to kiss her or get her to come to your place. It will only work if you display to a woman in the first few minutes of talking to her that you are different, not a wimpy, simp, nice guy, and have some of these qualities women are looking for in a man, like humor, like being cheeky, like being dominant, like being rebellious. But if you F it up, if you screw it up, there is nothing that you could do about it because she's actually made up her mind. That's why you will have to make sure you get it right from the start. Once she has this image of you that you planted in her head, you can't get a change. If she sees you as a nice guy who is sweet, but only as her buddy material, you're in a friend zone, it will stay that way. If she gets attracted to you and sees you as a potential lover or boyfriend or husband, then she will keep her options open. But if on the other hand, if she makes a good first impression, as if you display to her that you have the qualities women are looking for, she will get attracted to you just like that, almost instantly. See, there's no choice here, right? She doesn't say, wow, he's funny, cute, kind of sexy. I think it's time to get attracted to him. It happens instantly. It's part of her psyche. Attraction happens instantly. Did you hear that, Marty Ma? Let me say that again. Attraction happens instantly. You see a beautiful woman, Marty Ma, walking down the street. You instantly get attracted and want to meet her. If she gets attracted, you have passed the nice guy test, as I call it. And she will now keep her options open and will decide if you're going to be her boyfriend, a lover, or maybe even a husband. They don't say to themselves, ah, he's so sexy. I'm so going to sleep with him. I'm so going to sleep with him. I'm so going to F him. Doesn't happen like that. They will keep the option open and see what will happen next. They don't really say yes. They only say no, or I want to see more. And in 99% of the cases, she will sleep with you and then tell her girlfriends about it. We had sex last night, but it just happened. You know, like it was your fault or something that she slept with you because she wanted to see what's going to happen. That's how women get down, man. That's how women get down. So with that, I think I'm going to stop right here for now, man. I've been talking for an hour and something. I don't want to give up too much. I'm going to stop right here for now, man. I'll put out another one tomorrow in a couple days, man. We'll talk about these modernized women in the so-called 21st century. Go back, watch this video a few times. A lot of valuable information in it. Share it. And I guess I'll see you tonight at 8:30, man, on the Deprogramming Enlightenment channel. And if you just tune in for this channel for the first time, be sure to subscribe. Not a lot of people know about this channel. I'm going to say shalom for now, man. Tell the dog is out.